Transportation infrastructure, and specifically many concrete structures, are designed and built to last for decades while enduring a wide range of weather conditions. Transportation agencies expect one key attribute from concrete: durability. Agencies are continually looking for products that enhance durability while maintaining high quality and low costs. Using supplementary cementitious materials, or SCMs, in concrete help agencies meet these requirements. Over 2,000 years ago, the Romans understood that certain volcanic materials, now called pozzolans, when finely ground and mixed with lime and sand, yielded a mortar that was cementitious, water-resistant, and very strong. Both the Pantheon Temple and the Roman Colosseum were built with high volumes of volcanic ash in the cement mixture. These ancient Roman concrete mixtures were characterized by low cementitious material content, low water content, a very slow rate of development, and little shrinking or cracking from drying. Prior to the 1980s, Portland cement was used in paving mixtures for conventional concrete as the sole binder. These ingredients, when heated at high temperatures, combine to form a rock-like substance that is ground into the fine powder, commonly known as Portland cement. Since the 80s, use of SCMs in concrete mixtures, directly or as components of blended cements, continues to increase due to a number of technical and environmental benefits. There are four main types of SCMs: fly ash, slag cement, silica fume, and natural pozzolans. SCMs contribute to the properties of a cementitious mixture and affect the pozzolanic or hydraulic properties. Pozzolanic reactivity requires both water and calcium hydroxide as reactants with the material in order for the mixture to harden. Hydraulic reactivity needs water alone for a material to harden. SCMs reduce water demand, and therefore water cementitious ratio can be reduced. Most also improve workability of the mixture. SCMs are typically finer and less permeable, often resulting in improved durability, long-term performance, and reduced life cycle costs. SCMs are effective at reducing transport of chloride ions through the hardened concrete, thus reducing the chance of corrosion of embedded steel. They are a cost-effective way to protect the concrete from durability distresses, such as alkali silica reactivity, ASR, and external sulfate attack. In hot weather conditions, SCMs can be used to prolong setting time and reduce heat of hydration, thus reducing built-in curl and associated early age cracking. SCMs contribute to reducing environmental impacts by using recycled materials. Also, by replacing a portion of ordinary Portland cement with SCMs, the energy, which would have otherwise been utilized in the production of the replaced Portland cement, is saved.
So Portland cement, fly ash, and slag cement come from different manufacturing processes and essentially hydrate or have a chemical reaction with water that creates these crystals that are the glue that keep concrete together, give it its strength. The more we can let that strength develop, the more dense and less permeable the mix is, and then the concrete can protect itself from things like de-icer salts and freezing and thawing water.
Fly ash is a byproduct of coal-fired furnaces. The airborne residue from the coal combustion process is commonly used in concrete. Coal fly ash has been used in concrete since the 1930s, with the first results detailing this use published in 1937. The first major documented use of high-volume fly ash concrete in the U.S. was by the Bureau of Reclamation to repair a tunnel spillway at the Hoover Dam in 1942. there is a wide range of chemical and physical properties that modify the performance characteristics of coal fly ash as an SCM.
Fly ash has a chemical composition that participates in the chemical reaction of Portland cement, and it makes the concrete better in several respects.
Fly ash helps consume calcium hydroxide and converts it into more calcium silicate hydrates. Fly ash may be pozzolanic, hydraulic, or exhibit both properties. Because of the wide range of chemical and physical properties, different fly ash sources may have vastly different rates of absorption, strength gain, and other performance characteristics. Two common types of fly ash used are Class F fly ash, usually derived from the burning of anthracite or bituminous coal, and Class C fly ash, usually derived from the burning of lignite or subbituminous coal. Class F fly ash is pozzolanic with little or no cementing value alone. Class C fly ash has self-cementing properties as well as pozzolanic properties. Typical dosage rates for paving concrete for Class F fly ash are 15 to 25% by mass of total cementitious materials, whereas they are higher for Class C fly ash at 15 to 40%.
And therefore, we have the potential for better strength, we have the potential for lower permeability, and with that, we get better durability, because most durability reactions and problems come about from the ingress of water. So we make our material more watertight and more durable in the long term.
Slag cement has been used in concrete for well over 100 years. The first recorded production in the U.S. of blended cement containing both slag and Portland cement was in 1896. Slag cement is produced from the molten iron and slag that is a recycled byproduct of the steelmaking process.
Some of the properties that make it unique is essentially when the material is placed in concrete, you have a lighter concrete than you would with regular Portland cement. For the ready-mix companies, it's a lot easier, the finishability.
Because slag cement is slower to react, setting time can be increased significantly compared to ordinary Portland cement, making it an ideal ingredient for mass concrete placement where control of internal temperatures is critical to achieving durability.
So one of the benefits with using slag in the roadway, especially out here in the Midwest, is that it does a good job of reducing the salt impact on the concrete.
The typical dosage of slag cement in paving concrete is higher than for fly ash, usually in the range of 25 to 35% of the total cementitious materials, although it can be used in much higher amounts. Silica fume is an ultra-fine, non-crystalline silica byproduct of the production of silicon alloys produced in arc furnaces. The first mention of silica fume use in concrete was in a 1946 U.S. patent, but the material did not gain wide use until the 1980s. Silica fume is often used in high-performance and ultra-high-performance concrete, such as mixtures for bridge deck applications and high-strength pre-stressed girders. Typical dosage rate for silica fume is in the range of 3 to 5% and can be as high as 10 to 12%. Concrete with higher replacement of silica fume can be difficult to work with, and silica fume is significantly higher in cost than Portland cement, so its use is usually restricted to applications that require high strengths and or low permeability.
While it might bring some workability challenges, because these small particles bring a lot of surface, so we tend to have to overcome that perhaps with chemical admixtures or changing our water cement ratio. But the addition of that silica has that pozzolanic reaction benefit, that we're converting the calcium hydroxide to more calcium silicate hydrate, and therefore we're building a microstructure with intrinsic superiority.
Natural pozzolans have been used in varying degrees for many years in limited applications. Natural does not mean that no processing is involved. they may require some processing, such as drying, calcining, or grinding to be used in a concrete mix, but some can be used as they are removed from the ground. Examples include diatomaceous earths, opaline cherts and shales, tuffs and volcanic ashes, pumicite, and various calcined clays and shales. The properties of natural pozzolans can vary significantly and thus may require additional testing to ensure consistent quality standards are met. One or more SCMs can be used in a concrete mixture, either to supplement some of the Portland cement or for their beneficial effects. SCMs affect a variety of properties of the fresh concrete mixtures and the hardened concrete. Depending on the usage, fly ash and slag cement can substantially reduce water requirements, improve workability, reduce bleeding and segregation, reduce the heat of hydration, and increase set times. Most SCMs improve finishability and pumpability as well. On hardened concrete, SCMs used in the appropriate amounts increase long-term strength, reduce permeability, reduce chloride ion transport, reduce ASR, and improve sulfate resistance, all of which enhance the long-term durability of the concrete. For example, using 15 to 20% Class F fly ash in the concrete mixture results in reduced ASR as quantified by a greater than 50% reduction in expansion of test prisms at 2 years, measured using ASTM C1293. Class C fly ash also reduces ASR, but to a smaller extent, requiring a replacement level of 30 to 50% to achieve the same effect. Another example is the effect of slag cement replacement on chloride permeability as measured using ASHTO T277. Replacing 25% of the Portland cement with slag cement can reduce the permeability of the hardened concrete to chloride ions by up to 50%, with greater amount of replacement corresponding to further reduction in permeability. Even a small amount of silica fume, either on its own as a binary mixture with Portland cement or in a ternary blend with slag cement and Portland cement, can substantially reduce chloride permeability as measured using ASHTO T277. As the amount of silica fume increases, the chloride permeability decreases. The use of SCMs continues to increase. They are used directly or as components of blended cements in varying amounts to make the concrete more economical, sustainable, and durable.